look, I mean, you've heard this. Your reaction, first of all.
Well, it's quite reprehensible. There's no doubt about that, right? I'm not, you know, utterly surprised by this, because I think that there is a pervasive culture of latent racism and the reproduction and legitimation of white supremacy that exists in all of our institutions. So, you know, one of the things that, you know, I tell my students and my colleagues is, you know, let's wake up and understand that this is a quite pervasive and common phenomenon that we've had the occasion and I think the blessing to hear and be overtly expressed, but which, you know, students and faculty members and people, you know, dealing with the microaggressions of white supremacy and racism have to deal with on a regular and ongoing basis. We have to be able to look at racism as being a very pervasive problem. It's not simply the manifestation of those who are marching in Charlottesville or those who are storming the Capitol on January 6th. This mindset, right, these beliefs and values, they walk among us on a regular basis. What this professor didn't do, she didn't register at all the fact that what she's expressing is participating in a history of tropes and racial constructs of Black people, Black students, as being not equal, not being as intellectual, not being as smart, perhaps not as hardworking, all of that kind of stuff. She didn't take any of the responsibility associated with how do I change my pedagogy and my way of teaching so to be able to not get this outcome that I'm getting.